Hello, my name is Sean Castile, Extension Soybean Agronomist here at Purdue University. We're going to be talking about soybeans that have undergone a number of stresses this season, with standing water, both in the ponding situation to just saturated conditions. Here before me is a field I was planting about the first week of May, and we're in the first week of July, so about 2 months later. And the area I'm standing right now has had standing water, and obviously most of the plants have been killed through that, just submerged and just death. This is really something that I want to consider about the fields that have had more saturated conditions, that the whole field is this off-green color, kind of a highlighter green. And now we need to assess those root systems, both in the root development as well as the nodules, and to see how active they are, whether they're dying or really trying to regenerate. As I break this apart, a big part of the decision of whether we have a nitrogen stress and whether we want to do anything, any rescue applications, is a matter of how far along is it in growth stages and vegetatively coming into reproduction. So in this plant, we're looking at one that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again, 7 trifoliates, and it's flowering out the top. Once we get into later vegetative stages, V4, V5, certainly by V6, if we're this off-green color across a good portion of the field, it's a great candidate for looking at some rescue applications with nitrogen. They've got the above-ground symptoms of that off-green color, nitrogen deficiency, and then as you look at the root systems, on this one in particular, they are whitening up. I am catching a few nodules that are bigger, that they're pink. But it's only one or two instead of, again, I've got 7 trifoliate node positions. I was hoping to have closer to double digit number of nodules, and I don't have that in terms of active nodules that are fixing nitrogen. Fortunately, this plant is starting to load up with nodules that are developing. They're white. There's a lot of them, so that's a good thing for us, but it's going to take some time. It's going to take another 2 weeks to 3 weeks before these nodules are actively fixing, so it's going to struggle before it continues to get enough nitrogen to grow and kind of come out of it. So a field that looked like this, not a transition like this, but a field that looked like this, V4, V5, and certainly V6, may warrant some nitrogen. And in particular, we'll talk about urea is a good source. If you can get it broadcast, most applicators can only go down to about 100 pounds of urea. And so urea is a good source. So then nitrogen can be taken up through that urea form, as well as once it transformed into ammonium. And then when it transforms in the soil to nitrate, the soybeans can take that up, but that rate should not have any inhibiting effect on nodules by that point. So then you get the combination of nitrogen uptake for the soybeans that are stressed out, give them a nice dark green while the nodules are continued to develop over those 2 weeks or so, and then they can take over. So in particular, fields like this that are nitrogen stressed, V6, give or take a stage or two, some nitrogen would be warranted. Nitrogen supply is very critical for soybeans as we go through this transition. We're going to go through a really linear, rapid increase in biomass and nutrient uptake, and nitrogen in particular. We need to make sure we have good nitrogen supply and root development.